no sooner these laws were passed, commissions were passed, the U.S. ambassador here sent out a tweet saying, you know, there could be money laundering, there could be these nefarious activities that can happen. Everybody has, you know, completely, you know, rained on our parade. And I don't understand why the Sri Lankan government is not calling on her, violating, you know, making such statement. It's pretty much violating her mandate here as the ambassador. But I don't see that happening anytime. She just, you know, runs her mouth and speaks whatever she wants and forgets, like, even with when President Gotabaya Rajapaksa gave the pardoning, she forgot that Trump did the same thing. And yet here accused our president and completely a violation of our sovereignty. But, you know, that's a different matter. But what I'm asking is she raised concerns about money laundering. She raised concerns about, you know, these could not be. This is because the United States has a fight against China. They're not okay with China because apparently trades and, you know, imbalances that's happening is not favorable to their position of superpower anymore. China is taking over the world. This is the truth, the ultimate truth. Now, what are y'all doing? Because if you said earlier on, if people have, you know, doubts about this project, about Sri Lanka per se, they should engage and be part of it. So what exactly is the conversation like with the Sri Lankan government and the United States? You know, be part of it. There's opportunities here for you as well.
Well, Mahesh, I mean, you're basically talking about the geostrategic situation that we are facing right now. So, unfortunately, Sri Lanka is the chessboard. The game is being played by other people using their own characters. And Sri Lanka is also the epicenter of this geostrategic game being played in the Indian Ocean. If you look at the spheres of influence of major powers or major players in the Indian Ocean, every sphere, every axis goes across Sri Lanka. Yeah. So this is the reality that we have to live with. So we are drawing this attention. Number one, of course, our location. Number two, of course, our increased economic involvement with China. So this is a fact that we have to live. But then, I mean, well, one should offer alternatives if that is the case. If they are not happy with us going ahead with the projects being undertaken by Chinese companies, there should be choices to be made. When in the absence of choices, it's very difficult for us to do things. Are we going to be this poor country forever? Are we going to be this poor until these big powers resolve their strategic issues? That's a problem.
If you're saying they should give choices, well, the United States can say, we gave you the MCC, you didn't take it.
Well, that's a different thing. It is a grant. It's entirely a different thing than a foreign direct investment for a business purpose. So I will not dwell on the MCC because it is almost a dead issue. But that was a grant. There were certain conditions attached to it. There was a huge debate in the country. And the parliament rejected it, people rejected it, so that is period. But it doesn't mean that we should not do anything with America. We should do everything with America because America is a major power in the world. India is the major power in the region. We have to work very closely with both these powers because that is, I mean, linked to our future as well. But then, of course, no one should tell us that don't do things with China. Because China is our main development partner, economic partner. But you ask a question about money laundering and things like that. Mm. I mean, I'm not going to counter the statement here. But one thing I can say very confidently, the law of the country will prevail in the port city. The law of Sri Lanka will prevail in the port city. Now, I will mention three specific laws in that. Number one, countering Money Laundering Act will be fully implemented, fully effective. Convention on Suppression of Terrorist Financing will be part of that law, fully applicable to this port city. Then also financial transaction reporting, right? These three, countering money laundering, countering terrorist financing, and Financial Transaction Act. All these things, three acts, will be 100% implemented, applicable to the port city as anywhere else in the country. So therefore, there is no room for any money laundering, any terrorist financing. It will be the law of the country. It will be through the law, bank, the central bank and the banking system channeled to the port city.